see any cotton around here lately?
Cotton here.
My name is my name.
DJ Cotton.
Your lifestyle was sort of a sunrise to sunset, day in the life, if you will, in South Central LA. It was like nothing we had really ever seen before, yet we couldn't take our eyes off it. 1993, a big year for informers, a very big year for bodyguards, and a huge year for gangsters. As Dr. Dre came straight out of Compton and straight out of N.W.A. to bring mainstream America straight into the hood.
Well, I'm peeping and I'm creeping and I'm creeping, but I damn near got kept, cause my beeper kept beeping. Now it's time for me to make my impression felt.
Nothing but a G thing. This was my first time directing a video. I think we spent about 70 grand, and it was just supposed to be like a day in a life of me and Snoop, you know, from the time we woke up until the next morning getting home.
Like this, that, and this, and it's like that, and like this, and like that, and it's like this.
It was just a fun video. We spent 2 days on it and just called out a bunch of friends. This is before all our friends found out that they were supposed to be getting paid to be extras, you know?
It wasn't really until this video that we really got to see kind of how the West Coast lives, you know, with that barbecue, the lowriders bouncing up and down, just a whole different vibe.
It took me right back to high school. It took me back to rolling on Crenshaw on Sundays in L.A.
You wish you was there. You wish you was at that picnic.
And the simmering soundtrack to Dre's Backyard Barbecue changed the face and the sound of rap for the next 5 years. The G-Funk era was here.
He's one of the people who helped to create what became gangster rap. You know, the sound, the feel, the look, the whole nine yards.
What all the homies saying?
It's a gangster record because the gangsters like it. Nothing but a G thing, nothing but a gangster thing, nothing but a ghetto thing. Don't matter, however you want to take it.
After it was released, every car that we pulled up next to was playing something from the Chronic, and I just kept hearing it. It was hot, hot.
And the writing was so damn vivid. It was scary.
Just that gangster glare with gangster raps. Them gangster tracks makes a gangster snap.
I feel like anybody's got a sound like Dre. You know instantly when you hear a Dre record, the cleanness of it and the grunginess of a bass line and just, you know what I'm saying? You just know it. I know a Dre track when I hear it.
Is it Dre? Is it Dre? That's what they say every single day in LA.